Stand by for action.
The way the internet works today, everyone is connected to each other through the same level playing field. But a handful of phone and cable companies want to change all that. They want to lock down parts of the web and make sites pay them more money to use it. Everyone else will get the slow lane. How will they do that? By killing one of the internet's founding principles, net neutrality.
So what is net neutrality?
I'm not even sure what net neutrality means.
You connect to the web through pipes owned by telephone and cable companies. But the deal is they're not allowed to mess with what's inside those pipes, whether it's Google or Yahoo, Lonely Girl or Bill O'Reilly, everyday citizens or business tycoons. Everybody's website gets the same speed and quality. That's called net neutrality.
So what's the debate? That actually seems quite fair.
Yes, almost too fair. It's as though the richer companies get no advantage at all.
The companies want to set up a restricted fast lane on the internet, but only for their partners and services. Only sites who pay them a huge fee would be allowed to use it, making them gatekeepers.
This is really a debate over monopoly versus the ideas of even the smallest person being given access to every person in our country.
That's what the genius of the internet was, that it made the First Amendment a living document again for millions of Americans for whom it had lost its meaning.
But this wide open access could be slipping through our fingers. It happened, remember, to television, radio, and cable. It could happen to the internet.
Protesters are asking for help to defend internet freedom.
The group SaveTheInternet.com delivered thousands of signed petitions
with a single refrain: save our internet.
Every day, as more and more citizens learn about the issue of net neutrality, they realize that the internet as they know it is very much at risk.
SaveTheInternet.com is turning the tide in this battle, exploding to over 800 groups from across the political spectrum, with political leaders, artists, internet celebrities, and over 1 million internet users like us who petitioned Congress to protect net neutrality. Together, we blocked an attack in the Senate in 2006 and sent dozens of internet freedom fighters to the new Congress. But the gatekeepers are launching a counterattack on Washington and on your state legislature. We need to raise the alarm now to make neutrality the law in our new Congress. Man the battle stations at SaveTheInternet.com to sign the petition, call your congresspeople, and share this message with friends. And stay tuned for our plan to build a faster, more open, and accessible internet in 2007. Use the internet to save the internet at SaveTheInternet.com. Here I come.